mother gave her life protecting me from the monsters. But when I looked into her eyes a moment before she died, it awakened in me the blood of my father that had been lying dormant. A fire ignited within me, and my emotions exploded like a hurricane. I don't really remember anything after that. The next thing I knew, the room was littered with the torn-up body parts of the monsters that had killed my mother. I was the only one left alive in a house covered with blood. I clung to my mother's cold corpse all night long, weeping and begging her to forgive me for failing to keep my promise to my father, for failing to protect her. I could never stand to feel that way again. So the day that I failed to protect you is the day that I too will die.
Thank you. Thank you. Father, would you listen to me for just a few minutes? The world today seems to be heading toward disaster. No, I'm not talking about Albert. The countries known as the powers are pouring massive sums of money into building up their militaries. Like children vying for the biggest collection of toys. And you know, at first I thought I would just use Yuri and the others. I thought I could use their remarkable powers to benefit our nation. Yes, just like the Japanese army was trying to do. But the more I watched that reckless Yuri in action, the more ashamed I started to feel. I mean, Yuri really isn't thinking about anything. He's not thinking of a national interest, or of politics, or of money, or of anything he has to gain or lose. He just sees that girl, and he sees all the forces lined up against her. And so he protects her, nothing more. Just like some comic book hero, you know. But I'm a little jealous. I mean, the really important things in life aren't about profit and gain, right? I think maybe I'll start searching for those things too. The truth is, I'd really like to search for them together with him, but... Oh, forget I said that. Thanks for listening to all my silly talk.
Thank you.